Welcome to Home Tiny Lab. My name is Christoph, and in this video, I'm going to speak over the new release of TrueNAS Core, TrueNAS 13. So I tried to do an upgrade, but it didn't went like it should have. First, let's have a look at the new release notes. Here are the release notes, and like you can see, something very important to note is the software lifecycle. Like you can see, now the state is the release here, typical use, general use, and it is suitable for less complex deployments. So if you go one line down, you will see there is the U1, and that's the release for business use, and that's suitable for more complex deployments. So you could say that from this version on, most of the bugs are out of the new release. Down in the file, you have the improvements. Look at those improvements if you have the need for them. Then there are the new features. Then there is a long bug list that they had solutions for. And then there are the known issues. That's something really important to read through before planning the update from TrueNAS 12 to TrueNAS 13. So if we look at my TrueNAS server, let's log in. I'm using the root account and password that I have to enter. So here you see the version that I'm using. It's telling that there are updates available. So I'm going to click on it. And we see here that I'm using stable release of TrueNAS 12. This is due to my first attempt that I've done to upgrade. Normally you don't will see this, but if you go and click on the downwards arrow, you will see that there is TrueNAS 13 stable community release only, not enterprise supported. This message, this lost port will be removed when they are releasing the U1 version. So here we have the footage of my previous attempt to upgrade to TrueNAS 13 core version. Here you see that I am in the TrueNAS 13 release. I'm going to start the footage. And I had a warning that I could upgrade, or a message that I could upgrade the ZFS filing system. So here you see that I am clicking on the clock and going to the upgrade pool button. This is not my system pool that I'm trying to upgrade. So here you are upgrading the ZFS flags and the ZFS version that goes with the new release. And then upgrading pool, confirming, and error, upgrading pool volume 0. This was the error message that I was getting. From here on, I rebooted the system to version 12, with the latest update in that version. And everything went normal again. So there was no harm done because it didn't execute anything to upgrade the ZFS flags. I'm stopping this recording. Going back to my TrueNAS server like it is actual. And let's go to the boot. And here you see that I have the 12 that is still on my boot device, but that my active one is the 12.0. So now I'm waiting for the U1 version to do a new attempt to upgrade. So I don't know if somebody else that's looking at this video had the same issue of if there are other things that were not working. Please let it know in the comments. And also let know what kind of hardware that you are using. So I am using an AMD Pro A8 processor. So I don't know if that has something to do with it or not. or if there are other things that, if you like content like this, please subscribe or give it a like if you think that this was helpful for you. Well, I hope that I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.